We are discussing chapter 2, stacks and queues in list. And these are very important data structures, stack and queue. We'll see what these are. We'll try to implement the insertion and deletion using list. We have already done the manipulation part of the list. Then we'll see what expressions are infix and postfix, how to convert infix to postfix, and how to evaluate the postfix expression. What is a stack? Stack, as you see here, there are number of coins being placed one over another. So if you want to pick this one, you will not be able to. Why? Because if you want to pick this coin, all these above it are going to fall. And this happens with, if you have a 10 glass plate one over another, say tennis ball in a container, or you have a pile of book or a stack of coins as you see here. So the thing is that the possibility in this kind of situation is that you are able to put or place the item only on the top, and you can remove the item from the top only. Means insertion and deletion can be done only at the top, or you can say at one end. So this scenario is last in first out. Means whatever or whichever item is being placed last, this item is the participant which is going to be, or candidate which can only be deleted or can be taken off. This is stack. This is the stack, and it is very important as far as computer science is concerned. Most of the thing, you know, in programming and internally in operating system, they are being done by employing or by using the stack only. There are two operations which can be performed on stack. First is your push, then pop. It's quite simple. You have this stack. You want to put something, that is called push. You want to remove something, that is called pop. So adding a new element on the stack is push. Removing or deleting an element from the stack is called pop. And please remember that the insertion or deletion or push and pop can only be performed at one end. So what exactly is push operation? Push operation, you are adding new element to the stack list. We'll be implementing this using a list, which is called the push operation. So first of all, what we have to see here is whether we are pushing, and if the stack is empty, when the stack is empty, what? There is nothing. If you're implementing it using a list, then there is nothing in the list. So if we have any variable or any counter, this is not pointing to anything. So you start with top, because you are only interested in the top element. So we will take the variable top, and this top is going to point here, right? So let us take top, and top, if it is empty, there is nothing. So we cannot give even zero, because index, this list or array has index zero, which points to the first element, but there is no element. So we'll take this value, you know, any value which is less than zero, that is, we'll start with top equal to minus 1, because this is now empty. So when you want to insert, you have to first increment this top value. That is, you have to make top equal to 0. That is, it is pointing to some value. Then only you can insert an element. So first you have to make increment top by 1. Then you add this element. Right? Let us see the logic or the algorithm, how this push operation is going to work. You will start here. You will say top equal to minus 1. You will input the new element, means you will ask the user that, okay, give me the number you want to place on the stack. Then you increment top by 1. Now, first of all, you have to increment this top. And then you will place that element which you got on the top of the stack. Means top index, this is the index. So this index will come and the value will be placed on the stack. This is how items are inserted in the stack, which is through the push operation. Then pop operation. What is pop operation? Pop operation is the removal or deletion of the element from the top of the stack. As we recall that there is only possibility that you can remove the element from the top or insert the element at the top. So first situation may arise that the top has the element is nowhere, means there is no element. So top is pointing to minus 1. So if you want to delete, first you have to check whether the top is equal to minus 1 or not, because that says that there is no element. If there is no element, how you are going to remove the element? So first you have to do, you have to start, then you have to check whether top is minus 1 or not. If it is minus 1, then you will just go here and say that okay, we didn't find the item, stack is empty, not here. Stack is empty and sorry, we'll not be able to do it. This is top. Means you'll not be able to remove any element because the top is saying minus 1. Otherwise, if top is not minus 1 and more than that, then the simple thing is, you just have, the first thing is to take out this element. Which you are going to take out this element and you can print it or do whatever operation you want. And then you can just decrement the top by 1. Top is equal to top minus 1. So, top minus is equal to top. Right? So, top you are decrementing. So, you have decremented top. So, first you have to delete the item. That is, you are just assigning the top most element to any element. Then you are decrementing the top. There is a logic, you know, inside. What you are doing here is, you are actually not doing anything or any deletion is not done. You are just, top is pointing here, say 2 is here, 3 is here. So top is pointing here, now you want to delete, you are just pointing top here. So this element is already deleted, because you are not deleting it, you are just ignoring it. Because next element is going to come, top will increase and it will, the next element which is going to come will be overwriting this, say 6 is going to come. So you are, there is nothing called deletion. You are just trying to, ignore that memory element. Then the next thing comes is traversal in stack. What is traversal? You have a stack. Now sometimes you want to traverse, say get hold of the elements which are, print them, add them, or all the operations you would like to do. So traversal is moving through the element of the stack. So you can display it. You should have an idea of how to traverse in this stack. You will start with the top. If top is minus 1, then you will say there is no element. We will not be able to traverse. There is no element. So you just say that okay, stack is empty and stop. Then if the top is not equal to minus 1, that means you have some element. Then you just have to go or use the for or while. Just start with the top element of the stack and just decrement the top value. Means, go here, take this top, decrement it. So, top will be this, top minus 1 will be this, top minus 2 will be this. So, till the time you reach the final element, that is, till the time you reach top equal to minus 1, you can just display the element. So, in Python, pop and append element, these functions are already there. You can easily use these functions. So you don't need to write all these what we have learned. Just append and pop will do. Let us see two versions of the program. But one is without classes, one is with classes. So you are going to implement a stack without class and without class, and next we'll see with class. The criteria or the logic remains exactly same. What you're going to do, first you're going to ask user that do you wish to continue, means it is going to come after. So first this line has to be understood that once this first option is done, means these are printed, push, pop and display, user has inputted the choice, and after that the things are done, operations are done, then you need to ask whether you want to continue or not. So this line is exactly doing this. So you can write Y and N in the brackets also. So if user say yes, you are going again with the while loop. Otherwise, you come out of the loop. So I hope you got this idea. Now let us start. So we start with an empty stack or empty. This is not stack. This is just a list. So this is, we'll use list to implement the stack. This is a list. You start with C equal to Y. That is a character equal to Y. We say, okay, user has said yes in the first go. These are printed, push, pop or display. So now user is going to enter the choice. If choice equal to 1, then we will ask for the number, we will append it to this list A. We will append this A to this S. If the user says 2 and we find that S equal to empty, we say stack is empty, sorry, we will not be able to delete any element. Otherwise, we will just s.pop, that is, we will delete the element. If the choice is 3, we will find out the length of this S, then we go from minus 1. See, we start with the last element L minus 1 and we'll go up to the first one. Means the stack will start with the topmost and then we come back to the first one. So we print this element. Otherwise, if these three options 1, 2 or 3 is not being given by user, you say just it is a wrong input. And then this line will come. Do you wish to continue? So till the time user say yes, 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 you are going to do it again and again. And at the point user says no, you will come out. So what will be the output? First of all, this will be shown. Enter your choice. You enter choice 2. So you want to pop. But as we go here, we say that the stack is empty because the list is empty. So stack empty will come. So then again, this line is going to come. Do you wish to continue? You say yes. Or these three options will be in front of you. You say 1. I want to insert an element. So this value will be inserted. Then again, do you wish to continue? Yes. Then choice 1, 200 inserted, 300 inserted. Now you want to continue? Yes. You want to, you will give the option as 2. The 2 is going to pop up the element or delete the element. So this 300 will be deleted. See, but this, the logic of stack is just like this. First 100 was added, then 200 was added, and then 300 was added. So first element to be relieved is the last element to be added. So this will be relieved. So 300 will be deleted. So this way you can go, and eventually if user says no, the program is going to come out. Now we have this similar program using the class. You can just make a class stack. And this you can implement the push and pop operation. So we have just placed a push operation here. A list you have to make which is empty. A function you can make push, input your number as dot append. You can also make a function. Just let me tell you that you can just write def pop and you can just say, first you have to check for the whether the stack is empty or not. Otherwise you can just give stack dot s dot pop. This is how you are going to implement that function. So if it is not there, but you can just write, as I said, def pop, then you enter the number, then you say, or you don't have to enter the number even. Just say stack.s.pop and this just pop the element, the topmost element will be popped. There is nothing to be given inside. Now display. Display is going to take the length of this s and it is going to show from the last to the first. So this is how the values are going to be printed. So this is the stack, A equal to stack. You are making an object of a stack. This stack is a class. You are making an object A. Then you are saying C equal to Y. Why? Because Y, eventually this is going to run and when the user say no, we are going to come out. So C equal to Y means these three options will be shown. Push, pop, display. User will be given a choice. If choice equal to 1, push will be done. Choice equal to 2, first it will check for the empty. This code can be written here also. Means you can make a function. But we have not made the function. It's choice equal to 2. Then a dot s equal to empty. We say stack is empty. Otherwise, we will delete the element. If choice equal to 3, we will display the element like this. So it is going to display from the last to the first. Otherwise, if 1 or 2 or 3 options are not given, then you say, sorry, it is a wrong input. Then again and again, this loop is going to go till the time user presses y. If it presses no or anything other than y, it is going to come out. So this is the output, push, pop, display, 1 means push, so 100 will be pushed, then 200 will be pushed, 300 will be pushed, or deletion you want, deletion will be done, and display can also be done, so this is how you display the things, and deletion can be done, so this is how this program is going to work. Expressions. What are expressions? Expression are nothing but the combination of variable, constant and operation, and these are, when they are combined, these are called as expression, and they are going to give you a single value or a unique value. So what is an infix expression? Infix operation, say if you have a plus b, so this is all we know. We have learned this by now in our academics till this class or this scenario. A plus b is the infix operation. We write in the book, we do every computation in this way, but computer doesn't do it. Computer doesn't understand A plus B. It understands postfix or prefix. So we have to know about postfix expression also. Postfix expression is nothing but A, B. This particular operator has to be placed after this operand. So a b plus is the postfix. When the operands are here and the operator is placed prior to them, this is the prefix expression. You see these examples. So infix is these are all notations. So the operator is placed between operand and infix. The operator is placed after the operand's postfix, and the operator is placed before the operand's prefix. So these are the examples. So how to convert an infix expression to postfix expression? We'll see this by an example. First of all, let us go to the example. A into B plus C. So A into B plus C, the resultant postfix expression is ABC plus into. So how you are going to get this? Using stack. So let us make a stack. Okay. First of all, see whatever is coming. There is one result list and there is a stack. So whenever you have a operand, you need to place it where? A here. Mean in the resultant list. Then you will go from left to right, or you will scan from left to right. The next comes is the star or into. So you have to place that star on the stack first of all. Then you found this. The next one is the round bracket. So this round bracket, or you say the open parenthesis, this also needs to be pushed on the stack, round bracket. Okay. Next has come the B, and you know that B has to be placed here on the resultant list. Then comes the plus. Plus, the operator is there, so you can't put it here right now. You have to place it on the stack or push it on the stack. Now, next comes is the after plus C. So you have to place C here to the result list. All the operands are to be placed here. Operators of parenthesis has to be placed here. But now there is a closing bracket. This is a closing bracket. So what you are going to do whenever you encounter the closing bracket, we have to pop the operators up to open parenthesis. Means whenever this closing bracket is encountered, you have to go till the open parenthesis, and you have to add all the operators inside this from here to here to the result list. So what we are going to do here is, we are going to place the plus here. So this is done. And now we are only left with into, that we are going to place here into. So the final expression would be ABC plus star. What is happening here is, we started, we added the left parenthesis and right parenthesis to the start. If it is not there, we can make it like this. Then you have to place this left parenthesis onto the stack. Then we check all the symbols from left to right and repeat these steps till this stack becomes empty. If the symbol is operand, we add it to the list. We add to the list. If the left parenthesis is there, we place it on the stack. If it is an operator, then we pop operator from the stack and add to the list, which has the same or higher precedence than the incoming operator. Please understand, if any operator comes which has the lower precedence, then you cannot just place here. You have to take all the operators here, then you can place this. Otherwise, incoming operator will be placed on the stack only. And then when you encounter this closing parenthesis, we need to pop each operator between these parentheses and then place it onto this stack, right? And you can just remove the left parenthesis. So I hope you got this idea. Let us see one more example so that the things are much more clear. Okay. A divided by B, this is power, B to the power C minus D. So what you are going to do here is, let us make a stack first. First, A has come, so we have to place it on the list. A will be placed here. Then, the operator has come, so you have to place it on the stack. The stack. Then, B has come, so B has to be placed here. Then, the exponent has come, so you have to place it on the stack. Then, C has come, so C has to be placed here. Then, minus has come. Okay, now, as minus has come, you cannot place it, you will be tempted to place it on the stack. But the thing is that minus has less precedence than these two. Line minus has less precedence than this exponential operator. So what you are going to do here is you have to pop this, place it here. Pop this, place it here. Right? You have to pop this. Then you can do what? You can, because these are being popped. So you can place now this minus. Right? Next comes what? D. So D has to be placed here. And then only minus is remaining on the stack. So you have to pop everything. This minus comes here. So this is how you are going to convert the infix to the postfix expression. How to evaluate the postfix expression? So this is the algorithm, you can say. But before we go ahead, let us take the example, then I'll come back here. Postfix expression. How to evaluate this postfix expression? First, we have to make a stack. See, 6 has come, place it on the stack. 5 has come, push it on the stack. 2 has come, push it on the stack. Now, into has come. Whenever into has come or operator has come, you have to pop these two elements or the last two elements and perform into and then place it again on the top. So 5 and 2 has to be popped. 5 into 2 is what? 10. And 10 needs to be placed here. I hope you got the idea. Now this into has been done, then 10 has come. So after this 5 into 2 is 10 and then 10 has also come. So let us place it here. Then 4 has come, so 4 will place here. After this, this plus has come. So plus has come, so you have to pop these two, 4 and 10. And you have to perform the addition. So this is 14. Okay? This 14 has to be, these are being popped. So 14 will be placed here. Then next plus has come. Again plus has come. So you have to take this 14 and 10 out and perform the operation 24. Then these are being taken out, so 24 will be placed here. Next comes the minus. So minus is what? We have to perform 6 minus 24 because this 2 has to be popped out. And 6 minus 24, that is minus 18. So minus 18 will be the result. Okay? This is minus 18. This is how we do it. So the algorithm says, or the step says, we have to check for all the symbols from left to right. And we have to repeat this until all the symbols are over. If the symbol is an operand, we push it on the stack. Any operand we push into the stack. If the symbol is an operator, plus, minus, division, etc., we pop the two operand from the stack and apply the operator between them. We evaluate the expression and place the result back on the stack. And the result equal to top element of the stack. The result is the top element of the stack. Then one more example is there, true, false, and true, true, not, or, and. So here true and false are the operands, and not, or, and NAND are the our operators, you can say. So let me make a stack first, then you'll be able to understand more. Right. First of all, what we will do, true has come, so let us place true on the stack. Then false has come, false on this track. Then and has come, then this is the operator. So F and T, F and T, false and true and is always false. So we have taken these two out and these are gone. Now false will be here on the stack. Then true has come, so let us paste true. Then true has come, let us paste true. Then not has come. So not is applied only on one operand. So this true has to be taken out. and not of two true is nothing but false. So this has been taken out. We have F here, false. Then OR has come. So this top two will be taken, F and T. F and T OR is nothing but true. These two are gone. True has come. Finally, we have AND. So F and T will be taken out. And we have seen F and T is nothing but the false. These two are taken out, false. This is the final answer. I mean, this is the top of the stack which will be our answer. Okay. What are queues? In normal life, at the bank or the fee counter or shopping center, you will encounter this queue. So this gentleman has come earlier than all these. He might have come last. Okay. So this is a kind of queue. And here is the ticket man. When he serves the first person, he is going to leave first. And this guy is going to leave last. And the other person, if he happens to come to this counter, he will be standing here. He will not be allowed to enter here or here. Right? So this is a queue. Queue is a very common data structure found in your computer algorithms, computer science, various scenario you'll see queue. And this particular queue is container of these elements where the insertion and removal are done in FIFO principle. Means first he might have come first, so first he'll be out. He will be out and then he'll be out. So first in, first out. And the person who has come first, as he is relieved, this person becomes the first here. Right? And in the similar manner, when this he has come, he has to wait till all these are served. Q, this is a data structure where first in, first come, out is done, and there are two possible operations that can be done. First is the removal and removal of elements from list. If we implement it using list or array, the removal is can be done from the one end and the insertion can be done from the other end. We call it as the front, we call it as the rear. So the removal is only possible from front, and the insertion or addition or appending can only be done here. So this is first come first out or FIFO type of FIFO data structure. So what we are going to do here is we'll see about this first, then rear, and these two are our end for insertion and deletion. There are various applications of queue. That is why it becomes so important. In a single processor, multitasking computer, job waiting to be processed form a queue. So whenever there is a, say, process, so we have long-term scheduler and short-term scheduler. They does exactly that. They place the item in queue. So first, whichever has come, then they are being processed first. So you have all that round robin, and you know there are number of short time, short task first, all these scheduling there are. But the basic thing is they are placed in the queue. Then if you compile high level language, then also queue is formed. In a download manager, the multiple files also uses queue for ordering the file. In a multi user OS, job scheduling is done through queue. The queue operations, as I said, there are two operations which are possible mostly in your queue. First is your removal, and removal can be done from the front only, or the addition can only be done on rear. So first you can first operation is to create a queue. So we can store elements in order, insertion of an element at rear and deletion of element here from the front. So let us understand this with the help of an example. If you say you have an array or a list, then this is how it is right now. It is empty. So now when it is empty, if even if it is an array or a list, then there is no element. So front will point to what? Minus 1. And rear also minus 1. Because if front and rear points to 0, then we see that as array and list are described, 0 index means one element is there. Because there is no element, the front and rear should be pointing to minus 1 or should have value minus 1. Next thing is, let us add or append the value 5. So this will be added where? At the rear. So now the front, because front has nothing, so front will be also the first one, rear will also be the first one. So front and rear will point to the same element. Now second is, let us add one more element, 15. So rear is going to point here. So rear is going to be added or it will be incremented. Now you want to delete this 5, so it will be decremented from the or relieved from the front. So 5 will be relieved or deleted. Now this 5, the F has to point to this 15. So now again, the front and rear are the same. Because there is only one element. Now you want to add 25. When you add 25 here, then you have to, adding can only be done at the rear. So rear has to be incremented. So rear has to be incremented. Then again you want to add 35. So 35 is added. So rear now points to 35. Like this. Rear will be pointing here. And then you want to delete, so 15 will be deleted, F will point now to 25. And if you want to delete again, F is going to point again to 35. So this is how insertion and deletion is being done. There are situations which we need to understand that, first of all, if the queue is empty, will you be able to delete anything? No. If you want to delete an element from an array or a list, and this list or array contains no element, this is called the underflow condition. If you have an array or a list, you know, if you go to C, C++, Java, etc., then the list, the array has to be fixed. But in Python, etc., the dynamically typed language, where list, a form of array only, it can be extended. Or the size is not fixed. It can be extended. So whenever you want to add one more element in an array, and if this list, this array is full, then you will encounter what? You will encounter overflow. Because there is no place you can add. But languages like Python, you don't have to deal with this overflow, because the list, we are dealing with list, so it can be extended. But we have to deal with the underflow condition. So what is the algorithm? How can we insert an element? We'll start. Check for front and rear value. If they both are minus 1, we say that this is insertion. That means we have no element. So front, we will first increment the F and R, or front or this rear with 1. Then we'll add the element to the rear. So new element will be added to the rear point on the back. The algorithm for deletion is, you have a list, you want to delete. Now you have to check whether this list at all has an element or not. If it has no element, you will not be able to delete. So that will be a condition which we call as underflow. So we have to check for underflow condition if front equal to minus 1. And you have to appropriately show the message. Then what you have to do is, you can delete the item from the front, and then if you can delete it, if front equal to rear, then front rear equal to minus 1, otherwise you just increment by 1. Front you have to increase, because you have added an element or deleted an element. If you have deleted an element, you have to increase the front, because this part is now done. So this is how item is being deleted, right? And the basic thing is, in languages like Python, there are already inbuilt functions for that. If you want to traverse, you just have to see that whether F or the front is minus 1 or not. If front is minus 1, there is no element, Q is empty. Otherwise, we just have to use a for or while loop, and you can traverse F till you go to the rear. Okay, rear point. So we have already del and append functions in Python that deal with this. So front and rear they are already being employed and being implemented in Python, so you don't have to worry about that. Let us see the program to implement queue using list, but here we are going to do without the class, and we'll also see with class. So how to implement a queue? You can just make an empty list, then you say C equal to Y, because first of all, when you run this code, you want to show these to the user. Print, these are the options being shown to the user. Insert, delete, display. Then enter your choice. User will enter either insert, delete, or display. One, if choice is one, new value will be appended. So A, this one, dot append B. So this B will be appended to this A. If choice is two, first you will check whether A is empty or not. If it is empty, we say Q is empty. Otherwise, you delete the item A0. You'd have to just say delete A0. If choice is 3, you want to display it, you will just check the length of A and do a for loop from I to this length and print AI. And otherwise, if user does not put 1, 2 or 3, you will say it is a wrong input. And then you will ask user whether you want to continue or not. If he presses yes, it will go. Otherwise, any other character, then Y will stop this program. This is a program of implementing queue using class. So we can use a class called queue. You can make a queue that is an empty list. You can implement insertion, deletion, and display function. In insertion, you will ask for an element and you will just append in this class queue.append, and this A will be appended. Deletion, you will check for whether it is empty or not, because you have to check for the underflow condition. Otherwise, you will simply delete q.q0. So this will be deleted. And then you want to display, so you have to find out the length of this queue, and then you can just from I to range, means all the elements you are going to print. Then you will make an object A, say C equal to Y, because while C equal to Y, user will be shown insertion, deletion, display. User is going to input the choice. One is for insertion, two is for deletion, and three for display. These three functions, 1, 2, 3, are going to be called. If any input other than 1, 2, 3, you will say wrong input. And then you will ask, you want to continue. If user wants to continue, he'll press yes. Again, this while will run, otherwise it will come out. So what we have learned today is that LIFO, last in first out, FIFO, first in first out. Stack is a container of elements that are inserted and removed according to the last in first out at one end only. Queue is a container of element which the element are inserted on the rear and deleted from the front. Infix, it follows the FIFO law. There are expressions, three type of mainly expression. Infix, operator is between the operand. Postfix expression, operators are written after the operand. And prefix operation, operators are written before operand. So thank you so much. This was about the stacks and queues.